Доброе утро! Good morning! Добро пожаловать на мой канал. Welcome back to Russian with Nastya. Как у вас дела? Как у вас дела сегодня? How are you today? У меня нормально. I'm okay. The word of the day is переезжать. Where is the accent? Переезжать. To move to another place, to another house, to another country, to another city, and so on. Переезжать, the verb, the imperfective aspect of the verb to move. Good morning, доброе утро, Эрик, еще раз, one more time. So, let's begin. Today we're going to learn some strophes for Eugen Onegin, Евгений Онегин. In Russian, it's a very popular popular work of Pushkin. So, let's begin. Давайте начнем. Онегин руку замахнул. I will ask you to practice with me out loud, to try to copy my pronunciation and to learn this poems. Онегин руку замахнул. Давайте напишем. Онегин. And write with me. Онегин руку. Руку замахнул. 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 Онегин руку замахнул. First, I will write it down, then we are going to pronounce them, and then I'm going to translate it for you. Онегин руку замахнул. Скажите, say. Онегин руку замахнул. Practice with me out loud. It's very important to improve your pronunciation and your listening skills as well. Онегин руку замахнул means with threat, Онегин raised his hand. Руку замахнул, raised his hand. Yeah? Like he wants to slap someone. With threat, Онегин raised his hand. Онегин руку замахнул. Дальше. Иди-ка он очами бродит. И дико он очами бродит очи. Here we have очами. Очи is the old word for eyes in Russian. Очи. Maybe you heard this gypsy song in Russian. It's very popular. Очи черные, очи страстные. Очи are eyes. Иди-ка он очами бродит. And wildly he's looking around. Wildly he's дико. Wildly he's looking around. Очами бродит. Now, waking his eyes, literally. And wildly looking around. Иди-ка он очами бродит. Let's repeat it out loud. Иди-ка он очами бродит. Молодцы. Good job. Дальше. И незваных гостей бронит. И незваных гостей бронит. Так, здесь напишу. Бронит. И незваных гостей бронит. And he curses all unbidden guests. The guests that weren't invited. Незваных гостей, незваные гости are guests that you didn't invite. They just came. You didn't invite them. This is незваные гости. And he curses these guests that weren't invited. И незваных гостей бронит. Let's pronounce it out loud. И незваных гостей бронит. Угу. Хорошо. Дальше. Let's continue. Татьяна, the main character from this poem. Татьяна чуть жива лежит. Татьяна, it's a very common Russian name. Татьяна. Татьяна чуть жива лежит. Чуть жива. Жива. Лежит. Лежит. Татьяна чуть жива лежит. Татьяна чуть жива лежит. Татьяна is half alive. Чуть жива is half alive. Лежит is lying on the bed, maybe, or on the sofa. She's lying there. Татьяна чуть жива, half alive, barely alive, лежит. Татьяна чуть жива, лежит, is lying somewhere on the sofa or on the bed. Let's repeat it out loud. Татьяна чуть жива, лежит. Очень хорошо. And now another strophe from this poem. This one is about spring, spring coming. Улыбкой ясною природа. Давайте напишем. Улыбкой with a smile. Улыбкой пишем. Улыбкой. Улыбкой. Ясною, with a bright smile, ясною, ясною, природа, the nature, природа, природа, улыбкой ясною, природа, with clear smile, the nature, улыбкой, with a smile, ясный, with a clear smile, the nature, природа, the nature, with a clear smile, the nature, сквозь сон встречает утро года. Сквозь сон, through the dream, встречает, meets, встречает, 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 встречает утро года, the morning of the year, утро года, the morning of the year, года, сквозь сон, through a dream, встречает, meets, welcomes, утро года, the morning of the year. It's like he's saying that the spring is the new year. The spring is actually the new year, not January when it's cold and there is snow, but spring is the new year. Сквозь сон, through the dream, barely waking up, встречает, meets, утро года, the morning of the year. Let's pronounce it out loud. Сквозь сон встречает утро года. Сквозь сон встречает утро года. Дальше. Синея блещут небеса. Синея. Синея, 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 блещут, блещут, блещут небеса. Небеса. Синее блещут небеса. The shining sky is turning blue. Синее means turning blue. Синее блещут небеса. Are shining the skies. Here the skies are in plural. The sky is shining, turning blue. Да? Let's pronounce it together. Синее блещут небеса. So the sky is shining, turning blue, becomes blue. Not white with the clouds, but becomes blue, синее. Хорошо, дальше. Так, another strophe for this poem. Так, пишем. Let's write it down. Взойдет ли он тотчас беседа? This is from another part, from a different part. This is, we are done with this, the spring part. Взойдет ли он? Взойдет ли он? Взойдет ли он тотчас беседа? Тотчас беседа. Беседа. Беседа is the talking, the action of talking to each other. Беседа, и chit-chat. Беседа. Взойдет ли он тотчас беседа? The moment he appears, they speak to him. They have this chit-chat, they have a talk. Here they talk about the neighbors. The moment he met his neighbors, they starting the talk. Or the moment he comes to visit them, they start a talk with him, a chit-chat with him. Взойдет ли он тотчас беседа? Так, дальше. What is happening there? Заводит слово стороной. Заводит. 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 Завод. Oh, we didn't pronounce it. Let's pronounce it out loud. Взойдет ли он тотчас беседа? Okay. Заводит слово стороной. Слово стороной. Стороной. Заводит слово стороной. About how they started to talk about. Заводит слово стороной. They start this topic. They start this topic. And let's see what kind of topic. Let's pronounce it out loud. Заводит слово стороной. So they start this topic with him, this talk. О скуке жизни холостой. So his neighbors are starting to talk with him about the boring life to be a bachelor, to be unmarried. О скуке жизни холостой. О скуке. 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 Скука is boredom. Boredom. О скуке жизни. 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 Холостой. 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 About a boredom life to be a bachelor, to be unmarried. О скуке жизни холостой. Let's pronounce it out loud. О скуке жизни холостой. Очень хорошо, молодцы. Дальше. Зовут соседа к самовару. They're asking him, they invite him for samovar. Samovar is that thing, that big thing, where that Russian thing that we use to make a tea with, for boiled water. That big thing for boiled water. I think in English it's samovar as well, because it came from Russian. So they invite him for samovar, for some tea, basically. It means that they invite him for tea. Зовут соседа к самовару. Зовут. They invite соседа, the neighbor, соседа, him, соседа. They invite the neighbor, соседа, к самовару. К самовару. 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 Зовут соседа к самовару. They are inviting him, he's a neighbor. They are inviting the neighbor to самовар, for tea, yeah, for самовар, for tea. Зовут соседа к самовару. А Дуня разливает чай. Дуня is a very old Russian name. Так, каким мы еще? А, синим. Дуня is a very old Russian name. We don't use this name anymore. But it was very popular in 18th century. А Дуня and Дуня. А Дуня. Дуня. Дуня разливает чай. Pours tea. Разливает. Ливает. Разливает чай. Чай. А Дуня разливает чай. And Дуня pours some tea to the guest. Да? А Дуня разливает чай. Ей шепчут. They whisper to her. They whisper. Ей шепчут. Ей шепчут. Шепчут. They whisper to her. Шепчут, for, obviously, for the neighbor to not hear what they are saying to her. Ей шепчут, Дуня. And here we write what they are whispering to her. Дуня. Дуня. Примечай. Примечай. Дуня. Примечай. Ей шепчут, they are whispering to her. Дуня, примечай. Дуня, look at him, observe him. Like they're something like they want for Дуня to be with him, to marry him, because he is a bachelor, he's unmarried. So they're whispering to him, Дуня, look at him, talk to him, something like that. Yeah. Let's pronounce it out loud. From here, а Дуня разливает, pouring, чай, tea. Ей шепчут, they're whispering to her, Дуня, примечай. Дуня, look at him, observe him, talk to him, да? Because he's a bachelor, he's unmarried, right? Хорошо, очень хорошо. That's all for today. Все на сегодня. Спасибо за внимание. Learn this poem. It's very useful and to learn poems in Russian. It will improve your pronunciation, your listening skills, maybe your vocabulary, right? И увидимся с вами вечером. See you in the evening for a new vocabulary lesson. Спасибо за внимание. Thank you for your attention. И увидимся вечером. See you in the evening. Пока-пока. Чмоки-чмоки.